The last presentation in this session is Bogdan Ouatu and Daniela Gifu from YASH, Chatbot Intelligent Learning Systems for Smart Platforms.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, and the presentation looks good on the screen.
So the original title was Chatbots, the Future of Learning, and it's authored by me, I think you said already, and Ms. Daniela Gifu. So our position in this paper is that intelligent learning systems could become a substantial and versatile tool for aiding the achievement of every student's potential. And the chatbots would play a role in this, and they have been successfully used in education and mental health, would help teachers focus on meaningful interactions and keeping a balanced teaching method instead of focusing on the level of understanding of every student. And the social context in which this paper was conceptualized is given by the low number of graduates in Romania. It's the lowest in the the European Union, and only a quarter of graduates work in domains they studied. And this may be because these two problems, mental health and discouraging students of following harder harder university programs that would result in lucrative job opportunities. And this discouragement leads to poor choices in domains they follow because they're easier but are they produce unqualified personnel, mental health stigma is an underlying problem, and it can lead to academic problems such as poor attendance, poor social integration, trouble adjusting to school. And for a more in-depth analysis, please check section 2 of our paper. And chatbots, why should they be used in these intelligent learning systems? Is because there is of interaction and accessibility. They should be platform agnostic, in our opinion, could improve public mental health, public education, and essential data collection that would otherwise be pricey to obtain. And once they get rolling, they are very adaptable and provide fast deployment methods. So automated tutoring systems have been proved to produce learning gains similar to expert human tutors in computer-mediated interactions, and the ability to evaluate the students' assertions are indistinguishable from intermediate experts, at least in the field of computer literacy. And if you check our paper, you will find out that this may be because shared meaning is based on successful communication, but it builds really slowly in reality. Experience of tutors doesn't predict learning gains. Many professors suffer of burnout, and chatbots could help them suffer a little bit less. And information seeking behavior is shown more by the students who already understand the subject, opposing to those who are lost in and would never try to follow the class. So proficiency of well-being chatbots is moderate. It produces a moderate effect size in reducing depression, have demonstrated capacity of high retention, meaning that many people who try these chatbots in a study usually finish the study. So a classical problem was nobody finished or used any of it. So, and modules such as goal setting intervention have been shown to significantly improve academic performance and close demographic achievement gaps. And this could be easily deployed using an intelligent learning system. So many would say that the cost of producing such intelligent learning systems would produce diminishing returns, but it would be countered by improvement in public mental health, public education, essential data collection that would otherwise be costly, and ease of deployment of national modules such as new curriculum or psychological tools. Adaptability and fast deployment of the models are surely an advantage because they would ultimately necessitate less human labor than not having one, will help institutions prioritize where human labor should be allocated, would streamline the data analysis process, may provide new data and allow for more insights through the analysis of the data that is in natural language format, and this kind of data is very demanding in other fields and does not necessitate to the reprinting of tens of thousands of school books for every content mistake, like it was the case in the last few years in our country. So for conclusion, chatbots can be engaging, helpful, and high retention, offer educational and psychological support at once convenience, and intelligent tutoring systems could become a convenient and inexpensive platform for deploying useful models. Thank you. Any questions?
Okay. Thank you, Bogdan. It was very interesting. Like, this is a flash communication or a position paper, and you had a very good timing. Any questions?
I would have a silly question. Sure. I don't know, my general experience with chatbots have been mostly of annoyance. Do you have any, I don't know, a study of impact on people with mental health regarding this? When the chatbot goes into in a loop where it doesn't get out, or when it starts to get annoying for not understanding or not processing the information properly. Do you know a study of impact on people with mental health?
Yes, you could check its reference in the paper to WOEBOT. It's exactly for this, for psychological support. And it's true, a minority of people feel that the chatbot doesn't understand it, but surprisingly many refer to the chatbot as a friend, as someone who understands them, as someone who helped them, instead of referring to the programmers behind it. And there are some studies that point out that humans tend to use chatbots, especially if implemented well, and we can implement well chatbots. Start to consider the media as another human, and they communicate with it like it is another human. So check this paper, WOBOT study.
So and basically, because the chatbot is consistent and doesn't get annoyed or something, it is very useful to humans because it's very patient with them.
Yeah, and also it's because WOBOT has a hybrid input method, meaning that it usually lets you select from different feelings. So you may say, okay, I feel like this, like this, like this. And rarely it asks you to input full messages, and this facilitates for a better deployment of the product, so to speak, because it would fail less, because the input is less, the input space is smaller.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you too.
Okay, perfect. So if the conversation is guided on a given topic, then the chatbot is better. And I put a link to WOBOT, which is actually one in the chat, which is actually one of the top chatbot solutions, and they have really good feedback until now. Yes. Any other questions? Otherwise, we are ending session 5, supportive technologies. A big thanks to all the presenters, all the participants, and of course to the organizers. I